I know and I've heard that you are someone who has tons of ideas already for feature films, yes. right? And then you're also saying that you will accommodate these acting opportunities that you get with directors that you trust. When you are someone who's loaded with ideas, and then there are these good ideas that also come to you as an actor, how do you prioritize?
So that's the reason I'm also, developing a writing team.
Right.
So that few subjects I don't have to sit and write myself, I can give it to others. So I trust few writers also who are working with me.
Sure.
So I completely give the subject to my writers and they develop it. Sometimes, you know, although I give it to them, obviously, you know, the idea keeps running in my head also. For example, now I'm working more on Punya Koti, but I also think about Richie once in a while. It's not that I complete, because I'm excited to play that character once again.
Sure.
So whenever I think about Richie and whenever I get ideas, I give it to my writers and they adopt it. You take more time to write scenes and dialogues, right? So they write that. Obviously, in the last, probably in the last draft, I will have to sit with them because the Mangalore Kannada, the way Richie speaks, probably I will have to improvise all that. But otherwise, they are writing it. And I'm concentrating on Punya Koti. Also, Hemant is writing Tenali by himself. So this is the way I am trying to, balance it.
But is there even a timeline that you are aware of? Like all the projects that you just spoke about are big ones.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. So is there a timeline in your head? Do you know when?
I never.
What's
see,
happening?
I always have a timeline, but I never follow it. Probably I should get better in scheduling it and following it also. But that is something which I've learned through ASN because in ASN there are a lot of delays in between also. It's not that, you know, probably this film we have taken 3 years, but we could have completed it in 2.5 years. So we took 6 months.
So you're only reducing it by 6 months.
Yeah.
You're saying it will take 2.5 years.
It will take 2.5 years because there are a lot of things which we have learned while making ASN.
Okay.
Which we are not aware of. For example, we had not shot anything until now on sets. And right. So when the script was ready, I was wondering if we can really shoot this film.
Sure.
Because we need, and see, the first option was obviously to find the real locations.
Correct.
So we had gone to find so many forts and we got one location in one fort, the other location in the other fort. But we realized that, you know, every fort is looking different and probably it might look like a joke. That because if it is one fort, it should look like the structure should be similar
sure.
to one another,
sure.
right? And it was not similar, so it might look like a joke. Then we thought about putting coming up with sets, and then it started. I was getting scared because how do you put such a huge set, and we don't have that kind of a budget to put the whole complete fort set. And then we realized, okay, if we sort things by scenes, and if we know that, okay, we have only 4 sets, and we have to finish so many scenes in these 4 sets somehow. We have to cheat, we have to do everything, but we have to shoot it in these 4 sets.
Correct.
So that it comes under our budget. So we learned all that while working here.
Sure.
Also, we didn't have experience of, you know, erecting sets. I knew how the set should look like, but obviously...
Sir, when you say we, are you referring to your team?
My team,
or
yeah.
just Kannada industry in general?
My team.
Okay.
See, Kannada industry has been, obviously,
right.
big budget films, they've been doing, they've been putting sets for a long time.
Right.
But I'm talking about my team.
Sure.
So when Ullas came on board, I knew how the set should look like. And I knew this guy will do it. This guy has the capability of, you know, getting what we are aspiring for. And he did it. But for us, until Ullas joined us, it was a new experience for us, and you know we had to sort things out before going on floor. So there's a lot of things in ASN which we explored for the first time.
Sure.
Even in terms of writing also, Ulidhar Kannanthe, as we were talking, you know, before the interview started, Ulidhar Kannanthe was my complete innocence. That, you know, I had no idea of also about Act 1, Act 2, Act 3. I was so innocent in terms of writing. I just knew that there is a writer inside me. And I would like to explore that. But I didn't even know that a story has Act 1, Act 2, Act 3. I was so, uneducated in terms of
writing
scripts. Yeah. But I had watched a lot of interviews from the directors whom I liked. And the way they write. All that experiences I had. Also, I had a lot of memories from my childhood, which I knew that, you know, it looked good on screen. When I wrote Kirik Party, all I knew was there is Act 1, Act 2, Act 3. And there is some kind of a structure we have to follow while writing, a story. And that's all we knew. And with that, we wrote Kirik Party. For ASN, I almost I wanted to get even better in terms of writing. So I almost read around 10 books.
Sure.
A few of the books which I had read before, but I had not understood it. But now, since I had already written Ulidor Kannante and Kirik Patti, I had a reference, you know, that what went wrong and what went right judge that. So then I started reading books, and I started, whatever I should read, I should come and, you know, give that gyan to the seven odds.
Sure.
And I should explain them with the board. So that gave me, you know, it gives me a confidence that, you know, you know something new now. You know, when you tell it to someone and they understand it, you get that confidence too, right? So that's how the team works for me. Working in a team works really nice for me, because I get to, whatever I learn, I share with them, and there's a discussion which happens, and, you know, our idea gets stronger.
Right.
So yes, so because of that, the whole reading process and preparing for preparing to write ASN also took a lot of time.
So could you break it down in chunks? You're saying 3 years, you could have brought it down to 2.5.
Correct.
But let's look at the 3 years, and can you break it down in chunks and talk to us about what happened perhaps in the first 6 months and in 6 month brackets?
So after Kirik Patti, we were enjoying the success of Kirik Patti until I think it released in December 30th. On December 30th, the film released. And until the March end, we were, you know, going places,
sure.
Going to Europe, going to Singapore. I took the whole team to Singapore. We had a good show there. So we did all that. And once I came back, it started, okay, now what next? Hmm. Kind. But April 1st, we started writing ASN.
Hmm.
But so we had already had a first draft, right? And when we went through that draft, like, people were very satisfied with what we had already written. But I was like, this is not after Kirik Patti. This we had written before Kirik Patti.
Hmm.
Before Kirik Patti, this was the right subject. Now we have to at least, you know, bring in more of us right now, because Kirik Patti was a need. Hmm. Like Ulidor Kannante was my innocence, Kirik Patti was my need.
Sure.
And while writing Kirik Patti, we thought that, okay, it was also my life experience when I was doing my engineering. But otherwise, we thought that from the first frame to the last frame, we need to entertain people. That was the only intention. I didn't want to go really high on in terms of writing.
Sure.
It was all about a good experience.
So it was a conscious decision.
It was a conscious decision. And so after Kirik Patti, now we have a budget, right? So we don't have to do that. So we can get more of us in this commercial subject. We can get a little bit of Ulidor Kannante also. In terms of, not Ulidor Kannante, because Ulidor Kannante is a completely different film. This is a very fantasy film. But in terms of writing.
But you're talking about the seriousness of writing.
Writing. Yeah. In terms of writing, we can get a little more that writing tradition to the script.
Sure.
So, which is why, you know, again, I had to go through all those books, and we had to rework on the script.
Do you mind mentioning those books?
So, one of my favorite book is My Story Can Beat Your Story.
Okay.
So, that is my favorite, because it doesn't, see, it gives you a formula to follow, and it gives you an example of filmmakers like Quentin Tarantino, even in a script like Pulp Fiction, he has followed all those, formula.
Sure.
Christopher Nolan also follows that formula in the biggest films. If you go in detail, everything is followed. Exactly. But obviously, how do you follow it using your creativity is your ball game.
Correct. There has to be a superstructure for it.
Exactly. So that, and it is very simple to understand. So that book gave me a basic understanding of the structure.
And this after Kirik Patti.
This is after Kirik Patti. And we also compared that with Kirik Patti. That,
sure.
Okay.
While what, writing Kirik Patti, what are the boxes that it checks?
Yeah. So while writing Kirik Patti, we didn't know any of this.
Sure.
But we have actually followed it.
Right.
Knowingly or unknowingly, we have actually followed the whole structure.
Right.
And at few places where we have not followed it, that is where people have thought that il solpa lag ide.
Wow.
So when there is a proper writing structure, na correct follow maartu hodre, a lag iruk saadhyane illa.